If you use Airtable as a CRM, there's a good chance that you want to store some email information in there, especially as you have interactions with your different contacts. Wouldn't it be cool if you could do this directly in the email environment that you use? Well, I'm happy to say that now you can. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how you can build an automation so that from your email application, you can push a button and automatically add new interactions from your email into your Airtable CRM. Sound too good to be true? Stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, I'm Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting, where we help you to organize and automate using no-code tools. In this video, I'm going to be using a pretty cool suite of tools. I am using Gmail, I'm using Airtable, and I'm using an automation tool called Ply. Now, if you don't already have those different tools, you can go ahead and use our affiliate links below to start getting set up with some free accounts so that you can start building this and following along with me. Before we get into the heart of things, though, I first want to invite you to join me for some free automation training. If you haven't yet mastered the core building blocks of automation, this training is going to help you understand how all automation works, regardless of what tool you are using. This is tool agnostic, software agnostic training. You can grab that automation training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. We're going to go step by step through the automation. But first, I want to demo it for you. Here I am inside of my Gmail. And as you can see, I've got a little button right here that you've probably never seen before. And that's because I added this button using Ply. Ply allows you, if you're using Chrome, because Ply is a Chrome extension, it allows you to add these buttons natively to whatever software you're already using. And here I've said, hey, look, I've got this email in Gmail. I want to create this little button. If I'm inside an email, if I push the button, it's going to do the automation thing. In this case, it's going to search my CRM, and it's going to add that information. This email interaction is going to get added to my CRM. Let's see what I mean. I push this button in the bottom left corner. You can see the automation is running. It's being performed. And if I flip now into my Airtable, I have a new interaction that was just added just a moment ago, properly connected to the person who sent this email. If you go back here, you'll notice that I sent this email to myself. It has the subject of test subject, has the body of this is a test email body, and that is exactly what we see here. I've added the interaction, linked it to the appropriate contact inside of my CRM, and I've recorded that interaction with a timestamp. Now, if you're ready to see what this automation looks like on the back end, let's first dive into the Airtable schema. Really simple. We just have contacts. This is a full name, a text field. I've used formulas to break out the first and last name. This is pretty simple to do, but all I'm looking for here is the space inside of the full name, because it's usually first space last. And then I can extrapolate the first name and the last name using a little bit of formula magic. Here I have an email field, and I'm linking over to my interactions. One contact can have multiple interactions, so I keep this toggled on. But on the interaction side, we have the actual interaction ID, which is just a formula that's taking the contact and combining it with the created date. So I've got my link to contacts, but then more importantly, when I'm storing that interaction, I want to know what the subject was and what the body of the email was, and I have that information right here. I also have a created date field, which is metadata. It's pulling the actual date time that the record came into existence so that I can know when it was added to our CRM. Pretty straightforward, nothing crazy in terms of this data schema. Let's take a look at how Ply works. On the back end, Ply is a very visual builder. And so here we are inside of Ply. We start with our display button. Once that button is pushed, we instantly get the contextual message or the context of the message. We are then going to search for the contact in our CRM. If they already exist, we don't need to create a new contact. But if they don't already exist in our CRM, we need to add them. So that's when we're branching out here. We've added a branch. In our branch, we say, hey, if the contact was not found, then we have to create them. If the contact was found, then we don't have to create them. And here's something that Ply does that's kind of unique for automation tools. When you branch like this, you can create a branch output so that no matter what happens, no matter what path I take in the branch, I'm going to have some sort of output from that branch. I either need to know what the record ID is that we found in the previous step, or I need to know what the record ID is if we created that contact. Either way, I'm able to build that right here inside of my branch output. And then lastly, we are creating the interaction record. And this is what that final step looks like. Just as with any other automation tool, we have to first map to the base, then to the table where we want to take this action. And then in our case, we're using the output here from step 5. Remember, that branch output is either going to be the record ID that we found when we searched, or it will be the record ID that we create inside of our branch. So either way, we have that branch output, and then we're mapping back here to the subject that actually came from the email itself. We had this from the contextual message. And if we look through this, we have a lot of data that Gmail is sending to us, but we can search SUB for subject. We can bring in the subject line here, and we know it is test subject. And then lastly, we map similarly to the body. So now that we understand how the automation came together, let's take it out for a couple of spins using a few of the different examples, because remember, we want to make sure that it works in the case where we have an existing contact in our CRM, but also if that contact doesn't yet exist in our CRM. So let's test this one more time. Going back to our CRM first, we have 3 interactions right now, 2 of them linked to myself and 1 of them linked to another test. Let's actually group here by those interactions so we can see them a bit more clearly. And if I go back into my email and I click this button, then it's going to run and we are going to see that new interaction get added to Gareth here. And it, of course, has the new created time because we've been working on this in the background. But what happens if we delete all these interactions from Gareth? And more importantly, delete Gareth as a contact. We'll come back here and remove them. So now there is no person with that email address inside of our database. How do we get this to work? Well, if we push that button again, this time if we watch, it will actually create that contact record before it then creates the interaction record. And if we go back to our database now, we see that this contact was newly added back to our database. This question actually came to us from within our group coaching community because one of our members had said, I need that Salesforce-like interactivity where right from my email, I can push a button and take some kind of action. So that is what makes Ply unique and special as an automation tool. The fact that we can build these types of automations, but actually have some sort of influence over the applications that we're working in. You'll notice that here I am inside of Gmail. I never have to leave my Gmail environment because of the fact that I've added that button right here. If you're curious about checking Ply out, they are still in early beta and you can get signed up right now if you use the link that we provide. And when you're ready to start building these things, add that Ply extension into your browser. Remember that you have to use Google Chrome. And just as I've done here, create an add-on from within the application. And when you do that, you get the ability to then add these buttons right inside of the applications that you're already working inside so that you can start making them even more powerful. I know we went pretty quickly in this video, so drop any questions you have below. And in the meantime, my friend, keep on building.